you should ask. Will she allow abortion in the 8th month, 9th month, 7th month?
Come on.
Okay, would you do that? Why don't you ask her that question?
Why don't you answer the
problem.
Question? Would you
because
veto?
Under Roe v.
Answer
Wade,
the question,
you could do abortion.
Kamala Harris went on the offensive against Donald Trump in a fiery televised debate last night, getting under her rival's skin as they battle for a breakthrough in an agonizingly close election. The Democrat clashed with the Republican on hot button issues from abortion to democracy and accused him of being a friend to the dictators. Trump repeatedly raised his voice as he hit back at the vice president on immigration and the economy, branding her a Marxist and blaming her for what he said were the failings of President Joe Biden's administration.
Well, as I said, you're going to hear a bunch of lies, and that's not actually a surprising fact. Let's understand how we got here. Donald Trump hand-selected 3 members of the United States Supreme Court with the intention that they would undo the protections of Roe v. Wade. And they did exactly as he intended.
With less than 2 months until the election, Harris, 59, was under pressure to deliver after her sudden replacement as the Democratic candidate in place of Biden. Trump reacted to pressure from Harris by resorting to the kinds of finger-jabbing insults.
It's no policy. Everything that she believed 3 years ago and 4 years ago is out the window. She's going to my philosophy now. In fact, I was going to send her a MAGA hat. She's gone to my philosophy, but if she ever got elected, she'd change it, and it will be the end of our country. She's a Marxist. Everybody knows she's a Marxist. Her father's a Marxist professor in economics, and he taught her well.
However, Trump said this was his best debate, while Harris Camp also claimed victory and challenged him to a second debate in October. In a tribute to the late Minister of State for Defense, Sarah Mateke, President Yoweri Museveni has emphasized the importance of health vigilance and regular checkups for Ugandans.
But you could see in those discussions, that's when I interacted with her closely, you could see that she was very careful with her words. Doesn't just talk like that. So it's a big loss.
Speaking at a special sitting at Parliament yesterday, President Museveni honored Mateke for her contributions towards Uganda and reflected on her calm demeanor and thoughtful approach.
But we try to avoid unnecessary losses, because anybody who dies creates a gap on our side. And that's why, therefore, the fighters should also look at their life, not as just theirs. It is also ours, all of us.
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Mong, expressed her heartfelt gratitude and condolences to the President Museveni following the passing on of Honorable Mateke.
We want to thank you so, so much for always being there for us as Parliament. Thank you. We do not take that for granted.
The speaker further noted that this support was not the first but a continued gesture of solidarity, having been witnessed on several occasions in the past. In attendance were the Vice President Jessica Lupo, Prime Minister Robin Anabanja, members of Parliament, the family of the late Mateke, among other mourners. In Chisoro District, preparations to bid farewell to the late State Minister for Defense and Veteran Affairs, Sarah Mateke, are in high gear at her home in Bohgahe Village, Nyakabingo Parish, Chahi Sub-County, Chisoro District. According to the official burial program, her remains will be flown from Kampala to Chisoro at 9 a.m. Amos Hakizimana, the speaker for Chisoro District, said a council session will be held at the District Council Hall at midday.
We scheduled tomorrow's meeting at the lady's home, the family home, in Nyakabingo, Chai Sub-County, Chisoro District. The reason we did that is that, one, the body has been in Kampala since Saturday, and we thought that when the body lands in Kisoro, it wouldn't take a lot of time moving up and down to the district, and then proceeding home, and the family members have not yet even viewed the, the body.
Akizimana said the session will honor are invaluable contributions to both the district and national development.
The special council session basically is to pay tribute to the late Honorable Saranyira Mashitsi Mateche. It is not granted to every leader. One look at what has the person done.
The local organizing committee overseeing the barrier arrangements said preparations for the barrier almost complete to ensure a smooth and respectful ceremony.
Are going on very well. There are a few things that we had not sorted out, but right now we are on track because everything is in pipeline. As I talk, Parliament has procured service providers for food.
By press time, access roads leading to the minister's home were being repaired to facilitate the movement of mourners.